Hello and welcome. My name is Robin and you're watching A Robin Reads. Today I wanted to give you some Dutch book recommendations. I'm a Dutchman and I live in the Netherlands, so therefore I wanted to give you some recommendations from my country. Books you can read as well, because they are translated in English. And very importantly, I think that you need to read from different authors and from different countries. And I'm going to make this a challenge, I think, next year, because this year I'm a bit busy. But I'm going to give myself a challenge next year and read a lot of different authors from a lot of different countries. And I know you guys have these same goals, and I know a lot of you guys do this challenge, so therefore I wanted to make this video. So the first book I wanted to talk about is actually a Belgian author, and his name is Stefan Brijs. This is the book I wanted to talk about. It's called The Angelmaker. It is one of my favorite books of all time. Why? Well, it is weird, creepy, and yeah, very well written, and therefore I really like this book. So what is this book about? This book is about a guy who goes back to the town he grew up in, and he goes back there, and people are like, why is he coming back now? What happened, you know? And they see that he comes back with three children, very small children, and these children, they don't seem to have a mother. The mother isn't with them, and yeah, the villagers don't really know who the mother is, etc. And yeah, then there is just a very creepy vibe from these children. They don't get out of the house. They need to stay in the house, or they can go in the back garden, but no one really sees the children after that. So that's really strange. They don't go to school, etc. And then a woman from the village is going to be a nanny at the house, and you follow her, and yeah, what it's like to work in that house. And it's just a really creepy story, and I really recommend it. The next book I want to talk about is a very, very famous book. I think, yeah, a lot of people know this book, and it's The Diary of a Young Girl from Anne Frank. Anne Frank was a girl who grew up in the 1930s, and this is her diary from the Second World War. She lived in the Netherlands in the World War II, and in the Netherlands, Germany took over basically, and yeah, a lot of Jews were, as you know, they rounded up and went to a camp in the Netherlands to go to Poland. And she was a girl who lived in the Netherlands, and she was a Jew as well. And you follow her and how she first is a really normal, nice, awesome little girl, and then you see her growing up, becoming a teenager in these times, and she writes about these things that are happening to her. And it's a great book. This year I read the graphic novel, and that was also really, really great. I really recommend that one. The third book I wanted to recommend is this one, The Dark Room of Damocles, written by W.F. Hermans. And this is the Dutch edition of the book. He is a very famous author. And actually, I think he's one of the big five authors of the Netherlands. And I will put this one down because you can't read it. So the English edition. This book is also a World War II book, historical fiction. And it's about a guy and his adventures in war. It's also a really weird story. I can't really remember a lot about it, but it's really great and I recommend it to you. Then a book I think is really important is this one, Out of Mind by G. Bernlef. This book is about a man who is like, yeah, a little bit older, I think 60, 70, something like that. And Out of Mind, the title, you might think about something, and he gets dementia. And you follow him, losing his memory and losing the grip of the world. And you see really how it feels to have dementia. And I think this is a great book to read about that. And it was very well written. And it was just, yeah, heartbreaking. And I really recommend this book. Then also one of my favorite books of all time is this one, The Twins by Tessa de Loo. This is also a World War II historical fiction novel. It's about two girls, you see them right here, this is the movie, if you want to watch that. And these two girls are separated by, yeah, they're really little, like 5 years old or something. One of them is going to live in Germany, and one of them is going to live in the Netherlands. And you follow them and their journey. What the difference is between the Netherlands and Germany in World War II. And you also see, like, what it was like to be in Germany. And they really just didn't know things. And, yeah, the Dutch girl, yeah, just says to her sister, like, well, why did you do that? But, yeah, for her it was just, like, yeah, normal. And, yeah, she didn't really think about it and just went with what other people were doing. And yeah, it's a really great book. The movie was also very good, so this one I recommend as well. Then I want to recommend this book. This is the Dutch edition of the book. It's very pretty, I think. And this is the English one, not that pretty. It's called The Friendship by Connie Palmen. And this book is about two girls. And one of them is, yeah, a bit odd. And the friendship with another girl from her class. And the friendship starts like normal, but then it grows and grows, and you're like, what is happening? And it's a bit creepy and weird. So, yeah, I really recommend this one as well. Then also one of my favorite books of all time is this one. It's called A Father's Affair in English. And this book is about a man, and he finds out that his son isn't his son. His wife has died, and I don't know how he comes to know this, but he discovers that his son isn't his son. So he is like, what? And how did that happen? And, you know, he trusts his wife. What happened? And so he's going on discovery to find out who is the father of his child and what happened with his wife and, yeah, things like that. It's a really moving book. I really liked it. It's a good writing style and it's really great. A thriller I want to recommend to you guys is this one. This is the Dutch edition. And this is the English edition. The Reunion by Simone van der Vlugt. This is a thriller, more like a domestic thriller, how you guys seem to genre these books. It's not really a fast-paced thriller, but more like slow-paced, slow-burned thriller. And we call it a literary thriller in the Netherlands. And this one is about a girl and at her school, when she was like, in high school, so she was like 14, there was a girl who went missing. You can see it here in the picture with her bike. And that girl was a friend of hers, but they never discovered what happened to that girl. And a lot of years later, I think 10 years later or something, she has depression and she can't work anymore. She's just burned out. And yeah, then she starts thinking more about this girl and like what happened to her. And she goes on a journey to discover what happened to her friend. And it's a really great book. And this is actually one of the first thrillers I read, and I really enjoyed it. Then one of my favorite books of all time is this one. This is the Dutch edition. It's very big. This is a picture of the author. And this is one of my favorite books of all time. And it's called The Discovery of Heaven by Harry Mulisch. And he is also one of the five greatest authors of our country. And this book is a very literature book. It's about two guys, Max and Onno. And they had the same girlfriend in a short amount of time. This girl, she went with both guys, basically. And there came a child. So, the guys, Max and Onno, don't really know who is the father. But they're really great friends, and yeah, they don't really mind, actually. And this book is about their journey with the child. And yeah, it's really philosophical and theological, and just a lot happens in this book, and it's just great literature, and I love it. Then the last book I want to talk about is this one. This is the Dutch edition again, and this is the author. And it's called Summer House with Swimming Pool by Herman Koch. And Herman Koch is one of my favorite authors, and this is one of my favorite books of all time as well. This book is about a doctor, and one of his patients dies during surgery. And the doctor, yeah, he doesn't really mind. He's like, yeah, I didn't really like the guy. So yeah, I don't care, he's dead. But his family, of course, does care. And the doctor needs to find out what he has to do to, yeah, not, seem bad, actually. And, yeah, it's just a story about him. Is he a good doctor? Isn't he? What happened exactly with this patient? And so it's a bit mystery book, and it's very well written. And it's just amazing. So these were all the books I wanted to talk about today. These were my 10 Dutch recommendations. I'm going to do a follow-up of this video because I have a lot more Dutch books I want to talk about. And I want to read just more Dutch literature to recommend to you guys. And I hope you liked this video. Please give it a thumbs up, comment and subscribe. And I will see you later.